Lydia, remember you're pushing a perambulator, not a wheelbarrow.
Yes, Mammy Collins.
That girl's come on in leaps and bounds since you took her in hand. You try to set an example.
Scully-faced old crows.
What did you say, Nanny?
These pictures have big ears. Now, who do you think can run to the pond first?
Me!
Ready? Steady? Go!
Never fails.
Oh, freedom.
Nanny Simmons up to her usual tricks.
Oh, she's been foul ever since Mr. Bowles had a word about the christening cup. Even fouler than usual.
Guilty conscience.
Put it this way. She's just bought herself a very expensive new hat.
Lord Hugh's got a new hat. A Homburg, it's called. It's ever so dashing.
I'm surprised you found one to fit.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, you're wasting your time.
She's in love.
Besotted.
Well, we all know you've been making eyes at.
Lydia,
we're only teasing. Well, you wouldn't say he was big-headed if you knew how nice he treats everyone. It's funny, isn't it? He's a gentleman, but he's the same, really, as other men. But he ain't.
Miss Hutchinson arrived yet, Hannah?
Oh, she's due today.
I'd have thought you'd welcome a bit of new blood.
Just what I need, some toffee-nosed little madam to tell me what to do.
Not that you're prone to expecting the worst.
Tom wouldn't let Bertie have any more bread for the ducks, and Bertie got upset, and Tom called him a bad name, and he ran away. I'm not telling tales.
No rest for the wicked.
Poor little mites. 8 of them dead out by Limehouse. It was in the Chronicle.
Yeah, it's a terrible thing, typhoid fever. You know, I had a death with it when I was with my Viscount's family. Oh, poor little boy. You know, it started with him being fussy. He just wouldn't eat a thing. Then he got a dreadful headache, and before we knew it, he was burning up. You'd have thought the poor little creature had been dipped in pink paint. A rash of spots. Oh, it's a sight you don't forget in a hurry.
There'll be more than 8 dead in the East End before this is over. You mark my words.
Ooh.
Typhoid fever spreads like wildfire.
Yes, I'm afraid you're right, Mrs.
No more dawdling, Bertie. Come on.
What is the East End? Is it where they have princes riding on elephants?
These seem most appropriate, Mrs. McCluskey. Although I'm a little concerned about the strawberry tarts for tomorrow. Cook's hand with pastry of late has been a little heavier than it might be.
I'll have a word, ma'am.
And will you ask Edward to deliver these?
Of course, ma'am.
Something to say, haven't you?
Sorry, Bertie.
You all right? You look like you've lost a shilling and found sixpence.
I'll see you tomorrow.
This engine wants these delivered. Top one needs an answer.
Oh, right, sure. You're looking very nice. Suits you.
Just as well, since I wear it every day of the week.
Still, brings out your eyes. It's more blue.
It's green.
It's not.
Mrs. St. John wants them letters delivered today.
Nanny Wickham.
Hands washed. I won't be a minute.
Yes, madam.
In the future, I do not wish to see the children playing in the gutter while you consort with the footman.
Yes, madam. Sorry, madam.
Charlotte's cup.
I think it's probably best, Bertie, if we don't mention this to Nanny Simmons.
Lucky little devil.
Is that Master Hugh?
It is indeed. Here for dear old nursery tea.
I don't remember that you were ever particularly fond of tea.
I'm mad about the stuff.
Well, you might fetch the tray instead of standing there gawking.
Oopsie-daisy. Ah,
tell them Indian, Martha, who doesn't like China.
Yes, Nanny Collins.
That's China tea, Lydia.
Randall?
Yes, Mr. Bolts?
I wanted to clear up this matter of the christening cup.
Ah, it's, come to light.
As I said it would. Children can be very devious in my experience. They'll often lay the blame on others to prevent themselves getting into trouble.
Yes, Mr. Bolts.
So we'll hear no more about it? Randall?
No, Mr. Bowles.
I trust nothing of the kind will happen again.
No.
Lord Hugh.
Here, let me take it.
You'll do no such thing. It's a trapping girl like that, but it's here.
Eric or little by little. Dreadful pie nonsense.
And a little piety would do you no harm. I remember reading that to you. It's a lovely story.
Unspeakable little beast. I don't suppose you were ever subjected to it.
Oh, no, sir.
Good afternoon. This is becoming something of a habit.
One of the few which is both pleasant and utterly harmless.
Let him sleep. Do you think he's well? He smells odd, sour. I don't think it's a symptom of the typhoid, do you? Smell.
This is schmaltz.
What?
Put schmaltz, that's chicken fat, on his chest, and I also saw it into his vest for protection. Always this works against diseases.
Detectives investigating the violent death perpetrated in Limehouse during May have been assisted by a new description of the man responsible. The man, believed to be a member of a gambling syndicate, is in his middle 20s, of tall and athletic build, with brown hair. The description was made by a felon recently apprehended who confessed to being at the fight where the murder took place and from which the suspect absconded.
Oh, goose chase. If they said a one-armed midget with a ginger beard, they might have stood some chance of spotting this bloke. Good afternoon, Nanny Wickham.
Good afternoon. I was trying to match the thread for Harriet's flannel petticoat. I wondered if you have any.
Mary, take Nanny Wickham to the sewing room. There's bound to be something there to suit.
Thank you, Mrs. McCluskey.
I think she was listening.
She wouldn't. Too much of a goody two-shoes.
Some might call it respecting people's privacy.
Oh, look at him. She'll be respecting your privacy from now on at any rate.
What are you on about?
Mrs. St. John sent her off with a flea in her ear for talking to you in the square.
You promised to get a message to me if he's poorly.
A girl in next street, my neighbour. She has a baby like you and has to work like you. She pays this woman to keep her little girl in Uxbridge, in the country.
Oh, baby farm.
Oh. This is a respectable woman. I'll miss Billy, but there's no typhoid fever in Uxbridge.
Oh, thank you. Here, please take him.
For you.
What is it?
Do have Billy close.
Oh, you mustn't spend your money on me, Mrs. Bronowski.
Who said I spent any money?
Thank you.
You'll miss your train.
Miss Hutchinson's arrived. She's with an older lady. That'll be Mrs. Hutchinson's aunt. Mrs. Euphemia Saunders, I think she's called. She made Mrs. Hutchinson's match with Mr. Hutchinson.
It's a shame they can't be here to see to their niece themselves. I never mind sorting out heathens abroad. It's terribly late in the season for her to be starting, poor girl. What was it she had?
She had scarlet fever, I think. Or measles.
Have they cut off her hair?
She's gone inside.
Come in.
Evening.
Hello. What can I do for you?
Sorry. I came to say Oba didn't get in trouble with Mrs. St. John. Earlier. Only Mrs. McCluskey said it. It didn't seem fair enough, and I mean, I'll stop talking to you.
Yeah, well, no harm done, eh?
Stop it! Stop it! Honey! You killed her!
Enough.
He killed her!
I didn't mean to.
Then you shouldn't have been treating it like a whirligig.
No, Miss Harriet, no harm done.
He's killed her.
No, he hasn't. I commend her for you.
Really?
Magic, these are. What's that?
There you are.
Pajamas and tea. Now. There's plenty of time for that tomorrow.
I think he'd nearly
finished.
Well,
you're not paid to think, are you? I'm sure we couldn't afford you if you were, with all the brains you seem to have.
Hello.
Miss Isabel.
Gosh, you know who I am and everything. I'm afraid I haven't got a clue who you are. It was Nanny Binns in my day.
Nanny Simmons, miss. And this is Randall.
Miss Isabel.
But I know who this is.
Cousin Isabel. We went riding on Pippin and we fed her apples. And then you were ill and we had to go away.
Well, I'm much better now at last. I say, I've got no one to help. I'm absolutely drowning in things to unpack. You couldn't be a darling and lend a hand, could you?
Of course, miss. I'll come down once Bertie's in bed.
I'll put the little treasure to bed.
Thank goodness, it all seems to have sort of exploded everywhere. Great Aunt Effie's sworn to fend off all the young men who are destined to fall hopelessly in love with me.
My fear is for the young men.
Of course, but I must appear. appear helpless. It's all part of my charm, don't you think so?
Hannah, miss. I mean Randall.
I shall call you Hannah.
Excuse me, miss.
Oh. Oh, dear. Can it be mended, you think?
Well, it's faggoting, miss. Very delicate work. Have to be sent away.
Aunt Elspeth promised me a French maid, although that rather got swept away with her and Uncle leaving.
In my day, only married women had their own maids.
Well, that is no longer the case, Aunt Effie. I suppose Bertie's got first dibs on you.
Yes, miss.
But we can still be great friends, can't we, Hannah?
Yes, miss. Arnold.
You're very engrossed, my dear.
Hardly. You look pale.
Do I?
Quite ashen. You must have been working too hard as ever.
Oh, I don't know about that. You're cheating.
It's a pointless game, anyway.
Well, I'm off to dress for dinner. Otherwise, I shall make a pretty poor show next to my wife. Yes, I did.
It's from my dressmaker.
You've got to come quickly.
Oh, Bertie.
Charles will be fine. I just need to give him something to make him sick.
Don't make him sick. Make him better.
It will make him better.
Hurry up, Randall. Quick.
I'm going to give him this nasty stuff. I'm going to be sick.
My fault because I didn't look at him very early.
No, it's not. No, come on, Charlie. Come on, there's a good boy. Come on, Charlie. Come on, Charlie. Oh, yes. He's being colicky. No one could say any different. There you are. Godfrey's cordial. Calms and soothes infant colic and restlessness. You've been drinking. I think some fresh air would do Charlie some good. Don't you, Bertie? There'd be no trips to the park unless I say so.
Hannah, could you be an angel and help me choose a gown for this afternoon? I can't decide what's ravishing and what's an absolute fright. Desperation.
If that's suitable for you, Nanny Simmons. Of course, Randall. Perhaps Bertie would like to help you choose, miss.
Oh, of course. What fun. Come along, Bertie. A gentleman's opinion is just what I need.
There's a language of flowers. Your mother taught me. There's daisies, that's for innocence, and white roses, that's you are mine, and a pink one, that's I will wait.
What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Sounds a bit confused to me.
No, No. You are mine, and I will wait. And sort of innocence.
Innocence? Can't be talking about you, then.
You should go on the oars, Mrs. M. You'd bring the ass down.
Hadn't realised the occasion would be quite so well attended.
Nor was I.
Unlike you, young man, I remember the relief of Mafeking in vivid detail.
Really? Were you infantry or cavalry?
Impudent pup.
Thank you. I shall decline to punish you for teasing my chaperone. You is immune to punishment, I fear.
Not true. A harsh word and I wither.
You are fond of London?
Oh, tremendously. I feel quite at home, although I've stayed here very little, really.
Well, you seem admirably composed. When I was your age, I was all elbows and mad for horses.
Oh, that is the one thing I shall miss, being in town. Riding.
Ah, but there's excellent riding to be had in town, Miss Hutchinson. Hyde Park. I'd be glad to accompany you if you wanted a hack.
Oh, but I don't have a mount.
Oh, that's easily arranged.
Tom and Harriet are well, Mrs. St. John?
As ever. Perhaps a little too well.
Oh, nonsense. Mr. and Mrs. St. John have the most delightfully lively children.
Oh, Bertie's told me all about them. Might we see them? I adore children.
Why not?
I'll murder Pringle when I see her. What's she doing at the knife grinders?
She offered to go.
I bet she did.
My sash!
Hang on, my hands are wet.
You do it.
And no singing this time.
Oh, you do a turn, do you, Miss Harriet?
I'm a little bit in love with her.
I said that's enough.
Sounded very nice to me.
It's a vulgar song.
Papa almost washed Harriet's mouth out with soap. I could do a turn, Nanny. I know most of the charge of the Light Brigade.
I said that's enough about turns. Your mother and father want you to be nice, quiet children, not circus performers. Thank you. Right, let's have a look at you. You look very nice.
I'll wait.
What?
I will wait.
I thought Mr. Potter needed you to help clear away.
Lord Hugh's undeniably good looking. And of course he's titled. But he is just a boy. Now, Captain Mason. He has the manly experience of battle etched into his features. I wish I were paler. To be a femme fatale, one really must be quite pale. In fact, you'd be perfect, Hannah. Pale and interesting. Although a little too gloomy. Whatever's wrong?
I've been to see a friend of mine who's ill, miss. She's known to look after her and only have the one afternoon a week.
But of course you must see her if she's ill. Take tomorrow afternoon off.
But Nanny Simmons, miss...
Simmons will do as I say. Now, Mrs. St. John's way of dressing her hair, do you think it will suit me?
Well, thank heavens the children didn't disgrace us. Miss Hutchinson's a perfect charmer, isn't she? She won't be long getting some poor chap to fall in love with her. Her father left his entire estate to her, you know. Fortune in land alone.
Not everyone shares your interest in money, Arnold. If you'll excuse me a moment.
Of course. I just wanted to say, well done, my dear. Duties of the hostess and so on.
I'd like this delivered at once.
Victoria?
Yes?
Good night, my dear.
Night, Arnold.
Thank God someone's up. Father in bed, Constance in bed, though perhaps not together. No one to turn to for company but dear old Nanny Collins.
She's asleep, sir. You best keep your voice down.
I have, had I? Is that an order?
No, sir, of course not.
Got anything to drink around here?
Well, there's some cocoa in the jug, but it'll be cold. I can get you some fresh.
Cocoa? You are sweet, Lydia. Nanny Collins' secret sherry supply. Not so secret.
Best not, sir.
I won't tell.
No, thank you.
Lovely.
I'm sorry, sir.
Leave it. I think you've teased me enough.
Sorry, sir.
You little bitch!
Pringle not down yet?
No, and there's nursery breakfast waiting.
Don't suppose you need asking twice to go up there?
You are right. I will wait.
That's drinking behind my back. And those sherry glasses were my birthday present from the family. I don't know what you think you were doing.
I'm ever so sorry. It was Lord Hugh.
How dare you blame Master Hugh for your clumsiness and your deceit? You are a very wicked girl.
But if it weren't my fault.
Don't you make matters worse by telling lies. You were little more than a savage when you came here, and I have tried to set an example of... Oh, get out of my sight! I'm sick of you, you great lump!
That's everything, I think.
Right. You were sure about that, are you?
Yeah.
So, what are you doing your off day?
Going home, as usual.
Come on. You don't have to do that. You are mine. I will wait. The flowers.
What?
You're telling me you didn't leave me no bunches of flowers?
You flatter yourself, you do, Ned Jones. It must have been one of your floozies.
I'm sorry. I
should think so.
lots of Lucy.
No questions until you've finished your porridge.
Mrs. Saunders, Miss Hutchinson.
Good morning, Mr. St. John. We had such a pleasant time yesterday.
It was most kind of you both to join us. I must say, I am surprised to see you on foot, Miss Hutchinson, after Captain Mason's offer of the mount.
Tomorrow, I am to be provided with the barracks' finest horse flesh. Captain Mason has promised it.
And we can be sure that he is a man of his word. Good day, ladies.
Good day. Good day.
Refrain from sharing your circumstances with all and sundry, Isabel.
It is called conversation.
You had a pleasant time at tea yesterday.
Most pleasant. Although, of course, I would have preferred to enjoy your conversation tête-à-tête.
I've been considering how we might affect that very thing. Soon.
In your vocabulary, Victoria, soon is a remarkably elastic term.
Arnold is prepared for us to attend a luncheon party on Coronation Day, and I anticipate feeling unwell. I will, of course, insist that he attends the luncheon without me. I trust that you can make the appropriate arrangements.
Of course. Are you quite sure about this?
Quite sure.
Nanny Collins. Oh, you're not in the doghouse again, are you? And what is it this time? Not stirring her tea in the right direction. You'll only say you warned me. Lydia? Are you all right? You promise you won't laugh at me? Of course I won't. What happened? I was in the nursery. Nanny Collins had gone to bed. And I had all this ironing to do.
It's Lord Hugh, isn't it? Did he try and take advantage of you?
I feel so stupid. After all you and Jack said and all. None of the boys at home would have done what he did. Not without thinking I was fast. Oh, May, he said that I teased him.
Lydia. He didn't manage anything, did he?
No, I bit him.
Good for you. But why is Nanny Collins angry with you? Oh,
he broke this glass of hers and she thinks it was me. I'll probably get dismissed.
The Lord knows I am not a difficult woman, Mr. Fowler. I have put up with more than enough in the way of clumsiness and no manners. But when it comes to drinking in front of the little one...
Of course. You've never been one to stand for any nonsense.
That's right. And to think that I've treated that girl like one of my own. It's a lying I can't abide.
Now, there you do surprise me. Lydia's never struck me as a deceitful girl, whatever her faults.
Well, I mean, she's trying to put the blame on Master Hugh.
Lord Hugh?
Yes. She says it was he who broke my sherry glass. Now, what would he be doing up in the nursery in the middle of the night?
He has been spending a considerable amount of time here of late, Mrs. Collins.
I know my Master Hugh. That girl's only ninepence in the shilling.
Mrs. Lawrence, I was told you boarded children.
By whom?
A friend in London. I'm afraid I don't know her name.
Can't be a very good friend.
No. More of an acquaintance, really.
Do sit down, Mrs. Randall.
I have a baby, William. His father is dead, and my work does not permit me to keep him with me.
My heart goes out to you, Mrs. Randall. It's a story I know all too well. You're looking for somewhere to board the precious child.
Yes. May I see the facilities?
Naturally. I'll escort you myself. Seems like fate, doesn't it? One spare for little William. Show you the bathroom. Some say I'm over careful about cleanliness, but I do like to make sure the children have their baths.
Oh, not for me, Fowler. I must away. There's a second reading of this dreaded sanitation bill. Cabinet pudding was ill-advised. I have an overwhelming desire to sleep.
Then you'll be in good company in the Lords.
Ha! Father.
Oh, Fowler, could you ask Nanny Collins to have Lydia bring Ivo down? I'll be out later this afternoon.
I think Lydia may be out on an errand at present, madam.
At lunchtime? Oh, dear. Mrs. Collins isn't punishing her again, is she?
A glass seems to have been broken in the nursery, madam, and Nanny Collins feels that Lydia is to blame.
Well, lovely as she is, Lydia certainly is clumsy.
Yes, madam.
Perhaps one of the housemaids could bring Ivo down. I don't trust Mrs. Collins on the stairs.
Madam?
My fee is 20 guineas per annum.
20 guineas?
I was going to say for a full-grown child. For a baby, such as little William, my fee is 12 guineas, payable in instalments.
Please, Mum. The butcher wants to talk to you, Mum.
Please excuse me, Mrs. Randall. I always like to deal with tradesmen personally.
Of course.
What's all this in aid of?
Fowler had locked the port away and I wanted a drink. I'm afraid I was a bit of a butterfingers.
I thought I'd brought you up to be mindful of other people's things.
I'm very, very sorry, Nanny.
Well, you shouldn't go letting other people take the blame. You're a very naughty boy.
Fowler? It's not on. I mean, a girl like Lydia, she probably thinks, I don't know, you find babies in a cabbage patch.
She did grow up in the country, Jack. Still, she wasn't expecting to be treated like that.
What was she expecting? A proposal of marriage?
You're not saying she deserved it.
No, of course not. I'm just saying if she had a bit more about her, she might have seen it coming.
Even if she had. Someone like that, he's used to taking whatever he wants. There's not much any of us can do about it.
Now, you don't have to do that straight away.
Oh, I best do. I got Ivo's jacket to mend.
I sent down for a bite for you to eat since you missed your lunch. Well, are you going to let it go cold?
Thank you, Nanny Collins.
Well, you can't be expected to work on an empty stomach. That's best brisket.
To whom it may concern, I wish to draw your attention to the establishment run by a Mrs. Lawrence of the Elms, Uxbridge. She has in her care a number of children, ill-nourished and ill-treated, without their parents' knowledge.
There you are. Like I said, good as new.
Thank you. She's Harriet's favourite.
No, she ain't.
What's this? Harriet.
She must have been leaving the flowers and all.
I will wait. She'd have to, wouldn't she? About 15 years.
Oh, that was Cook's idea. All that langs of flowers rubbish.
Well, it must be love. Harriet's very partial to toffees. You've made a really good job of this.
I like mending stuff. Wouldn't mind doing it for a living. You know, apprentice to a carpenter or something. Some chance.
You could still do it.
Nah.
It's good to have a plan.
Is that what you got?
Loads of them.
Randall, there's a monster. You're sitting in the cupboard.
She'll think you're even more amazing now. My half day.
Yeah?
We could go walking. You still wanted to, I mean.
Yeah. Of course. All right.
Oh, good. I hoped you'd be up. It's as quiet as the grave, isn't it?
Yes, miss.
I shan't sleep for hours. I fear the season may seriously overtax me. I might suffer a nervous collapse. You all right, Hannah?
Fine, miss.
I hope you didn't find your friend worse.
No, no, miss.
Then whatever is it?
I'm just a bit tired, that's all.
I'm quite exhausted myself, but Captain Mason is taking me riding tomorrow, so I must be on top form. I may decide to fall quite passionately in love with him.
have a young man, Hannah?
No, miss.
It's surprising, really. You're quite pretty. But you have had admirers, I'm sure.
I suppose so.
How thrilling. You're sure it's not a beau you've been fretting about?
No, miss.
You can tell me, you know. I do so want us to be friends. Honestly, I'm vraiment sympathique. Though a French maid would have been such bliss. Well?
I can assure you, miss, it has nothing to do with the beau.
Oh. Do you know, I've been thinking, and I've quite decided, once I've left a trail of broken hearts in my wake and finally settled on a brilliant match, you shall be my maid.
That's very kind of you.
Oh, it'll be such fun to be married. Imagine the honeymoon. France. Italy. You won't have been abroad.
No, miss, I've always wanted to go. Italy especially. I've always imagined Venice. A gondola ride in Venice.
And you shall have one. I will insist you travel everywhere with me. Won't it be heavenly?
Yes, miss.
There you are, you see. There's simply masses to look forward to. Venice?
Venice.